Throughout the course, Carolyn and I introduce a lot of new concepts and terminology. To help you keep track of everything, we'll build a map of these concepts, often asking you to think about how these ideas relate to one another and where the new ideas fit into the grand scheme of things. Let's get started by writing down a few of the things we've talked about already.
The first and biggest concept we've introduced is version control. This refers to any system that allows for systematic versioning of content. That is, anything that makes it easy to create, store, and access different versions of the same documents, code, recipes, or whatever content you're working on. Here are some specific version control systems we've talked about. These are all types of version control, so we could draw lines between each of them and the version control node, and annotate the connections with labels like type of. But if we do that, our map will soon get cluttered with tiny annotations. Instead, let's use colors to indicate what type of relationship each connection has. We'll use this color of blue to mean type of. As you've probably gathered by now, the system we'll be focusing on is Git. Though we will continue mentioning some of these others from time to time, to contrast with Git, using our comparison chart. The most recent concept we've come across is the Git commit. This new concept is not directly related to version control. It connects through the Git system. And if we drew lines between every second order connection, our map would quickly get out of hand. Some of these other systems also involve some similar concepts to commits, but they don't actually call them that. So we'll just keep it connected with Git. Do you think that this should be the same kind of connection as the ones we already have? Remember that those were type of connections. Commits aren't a type of Git, but rather a component. So the connection here should be a new color that indicates a part of connection. We'll use green for that. And we'll add the label here. Now, this time, I walked you through the process of adding items to the concept map to give you an idea of what we're doing with it. Later on, you'll be asked to decide how new items fit in for yourself. Now let's go to Caroline to find out how to view previous commits in Git.